The yellow stripes on the side of your screen are starting points for some interactions in this program. To replay an interaction, rewind or fast forward to these yellow stripes, then start play again.
Professor Ludwig von Drake.
Hello there. Now, the first thing I would like to say is, look out! What are you doing with that thing?
Oh, you were playing a little joke, you little game-playing kid. You're going to play me because I'm the professor. We're going to play some games here. Anyway, let me introduce myself. How do you do? I'm Professor Ludwig von Drake. And today, boys and girls, we're going to play with Disney's Cartoon Arcade. You know, you can make an interactive game out of just about anything. As long as there are things to do, there will be games to play. And if you don't believe what I'm telling you, just wait till you start playing games of your own and everything with my friends Mickey and Donald and Goofy, because they're gonna show you what a good time you can have even when you're doing something scary, like hunting ghosts. Mickey's in trouble. Too many spooks. When you see a ghost, use your joystick to cover it with the blue glove. And then push the green button. That's how you make all of them disappear. Now, the trick is, you gotta get those ghosts before the candles are all gone. Well, what are you waiting for? Go ahead! Those ghosts never had a chance. Let's look on my magic screen right here, and we're gonna check your score. Now we're gonna take a closer look at one of the games people play when they look at the sky. They give funny names to certain stars. There's one I call Doris. On second thought, maybe we should stick to games that are a little more down to earth. Now, somebody like Goofy can make a game out of anything, even when he's shoveling coal. I promised Goofy I'd give him some help. I can't do it alone, so you'll have to help us. Just wait for that old stove door to open, and then push the green button to shoot the coal into that stove over there. That's the only way to get more points, which are nice to have at the end of the game. All right, now you want to get that coal in the stove before the shovels disappear. Now, ready there? Go! Great. Well, let's take a look at your score on this magical contraption over here. Oh, that score's looking pretty good. Speaking of scores, I just took my driver's test. I didn't need to study. I just got in my car and drove away. Well, at least I don't drive as bad as Donald. No one could. Boy, Donald's got a problem. Well, maybe you can help him by using your joystick to put together all the pieces of that tire. Remember what it looks like, because I'm going to mix up the pieces of this puzzle so you can put them back together again. Just move the glove over one piece and push the green button. Then move it over another piece and push the button again. The two pieces will switch places. Keep moving the pieces until you see the tire. And if you figure that out, you're really something, let me tell you. Thank you. playing. I take off my hat for you for playing so well. Now let's see how many points you've added to your score. Games that are puzzling have always been my favorites. But who cares about that anyway? We're gonna discuss what happens when Mickey Mouse is supposed to meet Minnie and Mickey is late. I don't have to tell you that this can be a very puzzling situation for Mickey. Because he knows that even though Minnie is understanding, he better get there on time or she'll... lower the boom on him.
Mickey Mouse, you're late for our date. I've been waiting here for over...
Wait, date? Oh my gosh, I forgot.
One minute,
you see, Minnie, I was...
You'll meet me at the dance in 15 minutes or... we're through.
Yeah.
You better help Mickey out. Otherwise, he'll never get safely across the street in time to see Minnie. All right. Now, use your joystick to move Mickey across the street. But watch out for the cars! If you get to Minnie before the telephones, things there at the bottom of the screen, disappear, you can play again and win even more points. All right, go ahead. Looks like to me that your scores just keep getting better. Let's see what your score is. Why this next game is called football, I'll never understand. You don't use your feet to catch the ball. You use your hands and arms and muscles. You throw the ball and catch it. Of course, some people prefer to just sit in the stands and watch the game while having a nice quiet lunch. They find it relaxing.
Go get him! Block the kick! Block that kick!
It's blocked. No, he got it away. It's a high spiral. The safety man's under it. He muffed it. It's a loose ball. Number 48's in fast. Oops! Butterfingers. Moose Williams got it. He had it. Now DeGrady missed it. Sebring boots it to the 50. There it goes to the 35. It's next ball. No, wow!
Oh, wow! What a game! But you want to know something? I don't think anybody on this team can catch the ball. Why don't you give it a try? Surely you can do better than those knuckleheads. Now, Use your joystick to move the hands under the falling football stair. As soon as the ball hits your hands, push the green button to catch it. Ready, go! Okay, let's take a look at the score. Watch the screen. Oh, look at that. You're a gridiron great. Now, golf is a game where you should always chart your progress. That is, if you're making any progress. Using charts is the only way you're going to get to the top of your game. But as we all know, it's not if you win or lose that's important. It's how well you swing your club. Help Mickey get the golf ball in the hole? Of course you can. You use the joystick to move it from the starting tee to the hole. But watch out for those traps. They can knock you backwards. Now, you can't see the traps because I made them invisible. I made them disappear. But they're there. Do you want to know something else? I hid a cow along with those traps. Now, a cow is not an easy thing to hide, but that's where they get the name Cowhide. Ha! Cowhide! Oh, boy! All right. Ready, set, golf! Well, with so many golf balls flying all over the place, we should take a look at your scorecard. If you have two rabbits and you make one disappear...
Wait a minute, that's it, I figured it out.
Magic is really just a game played with numbers. It's simple. Once you know the formula. No, eeny, meeny, miny, moe, catch a magician by the toe. No, 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 it's much more metamagical than that. And I know just what the answer should be. All right. Well, let's see you try this one. There's gotta be a way to make those rabbits disappear. Wait, use your joystick. Oh boy, this game is gonna drive you crazy. To make the rabbits disappear, just pick the ones that match. Ha, oh, that's the trick. Pick the matching bunnies with the glove and push the green button. Keep matching the bunnies until all of them are gone, those little cuties. Are you ready? Then go. You sure made some of those bunnies disappear. Just look at your score. After playing games outside, it's nice to come in where it's warm.
Hey, where's the pot-bellied? Ouch!
Oh boy, I almost got potted that time. What am I laughing about? Oh well, at least I wasn't hit by a bunch of falling pine cones. That's what can happen when animals play games like this. I'm lucky because he throws candy. Yes, sir, playing games inside during the winter is what I like to do. Because when you play games in the outside, even when it's warmer, you never know if Chip and Dale is going to show up.
Yeah.
why Chip and Dale keeps breaking all of Donald's teacups. Looks like my nephew needs your help. Use your joystick to move Donald's cup away from the falling pine cones. Move the cup left and right. You don't want to break it, did you? Ready now? Go! Sure makes a difference in your score. Now, I gotta tell you that these are some of the craziest games that I've ever seen anyone playing. So now it's time to try your hand at my Super Scrambler. I've chosen something that you've seen before with Mickey, Donald, or Goofy. Now, the trick is you gotta figure out what it is. All right, now, I'll just add up your score here. Let me see now. Okay, you get these pieces of this puzzle. Now, can you tell what this is? Of course you can't. That's why I call it my Super Scrambler. It's something that you saw with Mickey, Donald, or Goofy. If you don't know what it is, place the glove on a square and push the green button. Then choose another square. You can choose one that does or doesn't have a picture. And then push the button again. The two squares will change places. Do-si-do. Keep dancing those squares around until you think you know what the picture is. All right, now swing your partner. I mean your joystick. And here we go! For more fun, who did you see with this object? Mickey, Donald, or Goofy? Whoa! Now move the glove over the picture of Mickey or Donald or Goofy and push the green button. Which one is it? Oh, well, you didn't guess the right one. But don't let that drive you crazy. There's more to playing a game than winning or losing. Just look at that score of yours. And I'm sure next time you'll do even better than that. So let's play again. Now, the trick is you gotta figure out what it is. All right, now, I'll just add up your score here. Let me see now. Okay, you get these pieces of this puzzle. Now, can you tell what this is? Of course you can't. That's why I call it my Super Scrambler. It's something that you saw with Mickey, Donald, or Goofy. If you don't know what it is, place the glove on a square and push the green button. Then choose another square. You can choose one that does or doesn't have a picture. And then push the button again. The two squares will change places. Do-si-do. Keep dancing those squares around until you think you know what the picture is. All right, now swing your partner. I mean your joystick. And here we go! Now for more fun! Who did you see with this object? Mickey, Donald, or Goofy? Now move the glove over the picture of Mickey or Donald or Goofy and push the green button. Which one is it? You did it! You're my number one player, so in your honor I'm gonna throw you a big party and everyone's gonna dance. We're all so excited that you won it.
Thank you.
Oh, you sure did a fantastic job with that game. Why not play again?